Thank you, Mxolisi. I was looking at those numbers and I was thinking to myself, surely your shareholders have to be happy. It's the dirty stuff that's doing the business, right?
Well, thank you very much for the invite, Godfrey. I think what was also very, very pleasing to our shareholders is that given the current capability of the organization to generate more cash as the new projects are coming online, we are very confident that this increase in our revenue capability and cash capability of generating more of that decision was taken by the board to actually revise this dividend policy, which enabled us to actually create an environment where now we can pay a much larger dividend going into the future.
Right. I wanted to focus on that core performance because it was good, wasn't it?
It was a very good core performance against a period, I think, which has been very, very challenging in the market. And also given the fact that part of that was impacted by some of the impacts from the communities,
right,
where we had 19 days of inactivity in some of our operations as a result of social unrest in some of our communities.
Yeah.
So against that backdrop, I think the coal team especially did a fantastic job in so far as ensuring that they can be able to deliver the numbers that they have.
Yeah.
And as we are projecting also for the second half, we are also seeing a very promising second half.
Yeah, that was going to be my next question, sustainability, of course. So given the challenges that you have in the first half, assuming those are subtracted out of the equation, therefore the second half has to be better. But you are being very careful in the words that you are using here. In the statement, you speak of stable outlook, and here you are saying it should be okay.
No, definitely. I mean, sometimes, you know, we're in a very, very interesting industry, and therefore at any point in time, there are a lot of unknowns that can also creep up.
Sure.
So this is based on what we believe are the controllables that are within our means to actually manage.
Yeah.
And with that outlook, we are very confident that our second half will be a much better outcome than this first half.
Let's talk about pricing within that coal sector.
We've been very, very lucky as a coal industry in general that due to macro factors and also the supply-demand situation globally, that the coal price, the international coal prices, have relatively held. And of course now, including that is supporting those revenue projections, is where the rand dollar exchange rate is right now.
Right.
That on one side has also a negative impact on us in terms of the fact that our fuel costs are also going to be going up. We saw that in the first half of this year, our fuel costs have increased by 25%.
Mm-hmm.
But what we are also been driving is our operational excellence and our innovation excellence throughout the whole group, which has enabled us to actually retain and maintain our costs downwards. And to the extent that between second half of last year and the first half of this year, there was a very small marginal cost increase, which was far below the inflation.
Absolutely. So you've been working hard on that front.
Mm.
Let's talk about the $476 million from your sale of that titanium stake in Tronox.
Yes.
Has that gone to use? And the balance of it, is it going to repay debt? What are you going to use it for?
Well, there's been
everything.
Yes, we did the first tranche towards the end of last year, and the cash payout obviously happened this year, and so there was a special dividend that had been paid earlier on in the course of the year, first part of the year, and that was the first tranche. So most of that dividend had been paid out to the shareholders. There was some that we retained. There's still another 24% that we of shares, you know, ownership that we have in Tronox. And as part of our next drive is to actually, in the next 6 months to a year, dispose of the rest of that. So most of that cash again will be going towards giving that back to the shareholders.
You're not looking at trying to acquire other businesses, try to grow the portfolio base?
Hence why, you know, we're saying that at that particular time,
we
will hold some. We're not going to give it all, but we believe that in the cash generation that we are able to bring into the organization through our current operations, as some of our projects are ramping up, we will have sufficient cash to be able to meet all the capital requirements that we could that could be there, and also any possible acquisition costs. Obviously, as that time gets closer, then we'll see, you know, how much of that Tronox dividend we will pay out, and how much we'll retain into the business.
Yeah, I wanted to talk very quickly about your labor costs here in South Africa. I think everybody knows that every year, or maybe for those companies that do three-year agreements, there are these difficult and tractable negotiations that have been conducted with the unions as well as the workers. From your perspective, how have you been managing that side of things? How are labor relations? Are you likely to see the same situation as your major customer, as we have seen in the past few weeks?
No, fortunately, we've just gone through a round of negotiations, wage negotiations earlier this year.
Sure.
So we've got 3-year agreements in place. So for the next 3 years, I think what we're going to be doing is to ensure that we continue driving, you know, our productivity. We are coming up with new incentive schemes for our workers, which are more line on site in terms of taking the tons out. And so it's going to be to their benefit that they continue producing, but in a very responsible manner, because it's about quality.
Yeah.
It's not just tons for the sake of tons. But I think thus far, we have been seeing very good relationships emanating out of the fact that we are enabled now to share in the upside with the workers.
Absolutely. I think we must all be mindful about what is happening in the gold industry and make sure it doesn't happen. But thanks for coming in today.
Thank you very much for the invite, Gordon.
That's Mxolisi Mgojo. He's the CEO of Exxaro.